Another molecule in the benzimidazole family for us to break down is known as thiabendazole, that has a molecular structure that looks like this and is often abbreviated as TBZ. It's used for the treatment of threadworm, pinworm, and hookworm, and also for the condition known as strongyloiditis. And the way that it works is if we zoom in on a parasite, we'll see that they're composed of microtubules, which are necessary for structural support as well as transporting nutrients around the cells. However, if we zoom in even further on those microtubules, we'll see that they're composed of two other subunits, known as alpha and beta tubulin, that need to come together or polymerize in order to build those microtubules. However, when thiabendazole is added, it's going to specifically bind to a part on beta tubulin, preventing it from interacting with alpha tubulin. Therefore, because they can't polymerize, we see decreased amounts of microtubules being formed, which leads to increased amounts of cell death, and eventually death of the parasite. However, thiabendazole has also been shown to be used as a fungicide. However, the mechanism of action has not been fully elucidated, but it has been shown to inhibit a specific enzyme known as fumarate reductase, which is necessary within the mitochondria to build a lot of ATP. So we see decreased amounts of ATP being produced in those fungal diseases, leading to their death. So make sure to leave a comment below on the next molecule you want to see broken down, and stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin.